Welcome back, everyone, to what will hopefully be a better episode. Because I've been playing around with the computer that I've gotten, and for some reason the front audio jack for a microphone does not work. No idea why, but I have a workaround around that, and it sucks because I just got this computer about a month ago, and already issues are popping up with it. It's unfortunate, but I still like the damn thing. Anyways, in the last episode of Pokemon Engrish Green. Oh boy. I don't want to talk about it. And in this episode, I'm probably going to have to go to years of therapy just to get around it. Just to avoid those painful memories. Anyways, yeah, so I'm going to ditch this town and possibly find a better language elsewhere. Hey, wait, me. It was very dangerous. Very dangerous. Oh, God, we're already off to a great foot. It was very dangerous just now. The wild pet ran out from the grass. You can let pet have a try if there is a pet, but... wait for okay, follow me. Word of advice to everyone out there. This is a PSA to each and every one of you. If a stranger ever approaches you and speaks like this, run away from them. Call for help. Because this person is either going to take you to their crack den and make you their bitch, or they're going to take you to a candy van. Free candy van. And there's no free candy in there. How do I know this? Not from personal experience. Anyways, I guess we're just gonna follow this stranger who speaks in the broken tongue of the English language. Grandpa and others are very tired. this is gonna be the whole entire episode, isn't it? Is it Jack? I can't tell. It must be the cocaine I've snorted. Ah, really? I'm shouting! A weight of movement? Ah, Captain! Are there three pet? I can't count. How many fingers am I holding up? Haha, there conceals pet in the monster ball. Is that what they're calling it nowadays? It's not bath salts anymore. It's monster ball. I was famous pet trainer for my excellence, but now the crack has gotten to me and I am seeing the color purple. Exist3S. Okay, I cannot make this dialogue any dumber or sillier than what it already is. So I'm gonna take a drink really fast. Maybe this'll calm my nerves, but I very much doubt it. So Exist3S, give you one. Select, please! Oh god, it's like early Skynet in its beta form whenever they're still figuring out how to mimic humans. So they don't understand, please pick one, they just say, select, please! Without the spacing, by the way. Ugh. Ah, how sly! Grandpa! Also give me one! Yeah, don't be anxious, you little shit. Select one you like. Then Cap'n Witch Pet shall we look? Suspect! I'm an adult. Oh god. I was fast forwarding it. I forgot how sensitive this R2 button is because I had to fix this controller because it fell and broke. Suspect! I'm an adult! But you were just called a child, not in the last video. So I'm not greedy for food. Cap'n, firstly, I should make great efforts to be chosen out. I'm trying to comprehend what I just read. To press the start underscore key to open the main of menu, Not the main menu, but the main of menu. When depositing, pet reports that writes seriously and works hard, that is enough. There exists an analog to the illustrated handbook, but the pages are all blank because someone's been just taking drugs and he doesn't know English anymore. And I'm looking at this man. Scene PC even comes an email to me! The fuck? Foster pet stronger, fight, contest, trainer, here call together, the strongest trainer. The place is the headquarter of Pet Alliance Society, not Pet Horde Society. In Park Courts, Dr. Al Chider, that is... Okay, how many secret identities is... Dude, this guy's a triple agent or something. First he was Al Chider, then he was Otakata or whatever it was. I honestly forgot, it was on the sign in front of this building. And now he's Al Chider, or Al Qaeder, with a Y. Jesus, he must be going through some kind of identity crisis right now. Dr. Al Chider, please, a visit, please. Or have a visit, please. Okay, well, I've already dictated that I'm going to do a Nuzlocke challenge on this, and I'm going to do this a little bit differently. First of all, I don't feel the need to nickname these Pokermans because, A, the names are probably going to be freaking silly enough as it is, and B, I really don't think that I'm going to be able to fit much like in a 4 or 5 character space. Because if I remember right from whenever I did a practice playthrough of this, and by a practice playthrough, I mean I played through like 10, 15 minutes of it up to a little bit after this point, my brain couldn't handle it. Anyways, I forgot what order these Pokermans are in, and I don't think that I have, you know, a trainer ID. I don't. Okay, so I have a 6-sided die in my hand that I've been using with Hearthstone. I'm gonna roll it. If it's a 1 or 2, I'm gonna pick the one in the middle. 3 or 4, the one on the right. And 5 or 6, the one on the left. So, let me roll the die of destiny. It was a 4, so I get to pick the one on the right. However, let us first see who these were that I did not get. Shadow, lizard. It burns the fire on the tail from the time it was born and ends its life as the fire burns out. Why, flame pet, is there also a shadow of human figure? No. Next time on Game Theory, do Pokemon come from people? Yes. Absolutely. And Torto. He's a shell. Its long neck draws back the shell. Wait, hold on. Torto, not Squirtle. Whatever. Its long neck draws back the shell comfortably and emits out water. The pet stepped on the water is dependent on the tortoise. Dude, you're speaking in riddles. What does that even mean? And the last one is Bulbasaur. Heaven forbid that they give it a decent name like Shadow. It's probably terrible. Inken. 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 Look at his derp-ass face, I love it. Well, it makes perfect sense that I'm playing through Pokemon Green and of course I get Bulbasaur, but I am not complaining in the slightest. Is on the back of the plant from the time it was born and is fostered to become gradually larger and larger until it engulfs the beast and murders it. I don't know, knowing this terrible translation, that's probably what they're hitting towards. Really? What the? Okay, look, game, I was not fast-forwarding the time. I'm gonna have to, like, switch out controllers here. I thought this one would actually be decent, but it's not. Really? An unimaginable seed of plant pet. Will it do? Yes, it will. This pet is really very healthy and very good. Cap'n has received Inken from Ouchider. Do we nickname Inken? I've already said no. But I'm still doing Nuzlocke, baby. Then I want this! Jack has for Sea Shadow, because he's an asshole. The pet I've chosen looks stronger! Well, that's because you tricked me. Oh, I see. Even the wild pet come out. As long as you let him compete, you will go to the next door town. Thanks, Outsider. Okada. Outsider. I don't even know who you are anymore. But we already know, as soon as I step forward, I'm going to have to fight my rival. I'm gonna save. And I recorded seriously on the report. Wait a minute, Cap'n! It's difficult for me to get pet from Grandpa! Act as my opponent! I just popped the heck out of my elbow doing that. Oh boy. Jack has made a challenge. Jack delegated. Instead of sent out, that's a pretty fancy word, I'll give him that. Jack delegated Shadow! Go, Inkin! Combat, go all out and chirps. Oh my god. I'm doing this. I am doing this right now. Chirps instead of growl. When has a Bulbasaur in the history of Pokemon ever went chirp chirp? You know what? Let's go all out, because I'm fairly certain that's tackle. Faux Shadow chirps to a sail. Since when the hell has a Charmander ever chirped, man? Inkins, go all out. Keep going all out. Stop chirping at me, it hurts me. My attack is lowered, but the attack of pet hasn't hit home. I'm gonna assume that's miss. But unable to determine smoothly. What does that even mean, dude? You missed. Faux Shadow scratch to a sail. He's just gonna keep chirping me over here like a jerk. You know what? I'm gonna chirp you back. You die whenever the flame on your tail goes out. I'm gonna chirp that flame out right now. We are apparently just having a chirp fight. Chirp, chirp. Ow, he scratched me, Dad. You know what? I think that's fine. My god, this is gonna be the longest battle in this game, isn't it? Just this opening one, where he chirps me, I chirp him, then he scratches me. Which they actually got right, by the way, I'll give them that. But they go all out instead of frickin' the other thing. Okay, you know what? No, I'm just gonna use a wound cure. I'm not having this. You know, I just realized that this flower right here looks like it has an angry set of eyes right there. You can clearly see those are pupils and eyeballs, and it's just like an angry flower. Inkin has recovered. Dude, I had to like go through four lines of text just to get to the end of that. Well, I'm gonna chirp you right back, jerk. This is some high quality action right here. Okay, he's only doing one damage now, so I could stop doing that. Unable to determine smoothly. That's just like the best way to say it missed. Dude, he got a he hit home. He hit home. How did he get a critical hit? That's bull. This is bullcrap. This is bullcrap. Where's my hit home? When do I get a home run? You can't hit me home and I can't hit you home. That's cheating. Come on, he's only got like 4 health. I'm like on the edge of my seat right now. Just keep wasting chirps on me. At this point, I don't care. Oh, alright. Alright, just one more hit. Just one more hit. We got this, baby. Sweet! We did it! Thank the Lord! Holy crap! Oh my goodness. That's an innuendo. I got an experience value. Inkin, the level has reached 6! My attack prote agile and speci has apparently increased. So attack, defense, agility, or speed rather. Which I'm pretty sure the people who translated this game were on speed. And the special, which is special attack, special defense. I've won the contest with Jack. Thank Frigg. Well, how it may be that fool, it's so good for your pet. I get $175 now as a prize, as opposed to what it was earlier, which was the thing from Space Invaders. Well, compete with other pet first. You'll get stronger and stronger, Cap'n, Grandpa. Then bye-bye. I'm probably gonna have an aneurysm by the end of all of this. Ah, thought we saw it. We won't do anything because Dr. Ouchhider is an authoritative person on pet, but many pet trainers still respect Dr. Ouchhider. He has a shotgun, doesn't he? That's why you don't disobey him. That's why he's so authoritative, isn't it? I am also studying pet as an assistant of Dr. Ouchhider. I am also studying as the pet of... You guys are just two peas in a pod. Okay. Oh good god, what just happened? I'm gonna stop playing and switch out controllers. This whole playthrough has been a mess so far. First video, the audio is kind of goofing up. This video, my control is goofing up. So, I'm just going to stop while I'm ahead of the game here. And thank you all for watching this long and tedious video of Let's Play Pokemon Engrish Green. I'm going to go have a highball now. I hope you all have a great day. Thanks for watching.